Cars.com Auto Review.
Hi, I'm Kelsey Mays for Cars.com, here with the redesigned Lexus ES. It's a car that's played an entry-level role in Lexus's lineup ever since Toyota launched the luxury brand all the way back in 1989. This is the sixth generation of the ES, which comes as an ES350 and a first-ever ES300H hybrid. We've got the 350 here, and it boasts a number of incremental improvements over its predecessor. Some of the frills fall short, but we think Toyota has found the right styling ground with this car, and that plus the hybrid should mean plenty of new buyers. The ES moves from the Toyota Camry platform up to the Toyota Avalon platform, and now it's actually a little bit longer than Lexus's upmarket GS sedan. Up front, you see the automaker's spindle grille. It's using this across a lot of cars now. It's kind of more of a fat hourglass, if you ask us. There's no F-Sport package for this car. F-Sport is a sportier package that Lexus offers on a lot of its sedans and SUVs and hatchbacks. Actually, I don't think it's needed on the ES. Pretty sporty look overall. Cabin styling is a lot like the GS, with a split-level dashboard and a lot of overlapping layers here. A few misses. The ventilated seats in our test car, those are optional. They don't really get very cold. There's a stitching atop the dashboard that's supposed to look like a leather-wrapped dashboard. You get up close to it, and Lexus actually says it's a slush molding, and that's kind of what it seems like. Not really anything close to looking or feeling like real leather up there. There used to be a lot more chrome in the ES interior. They've replaced a lot of it now with painted silver. Doesn't look very good there, but a lot of nice amenities, things like one-touch power windows here, a power tilt and telescoping steering wheel, and real wood trim. Always nice to see that instead of the imitation stuff. Overall cabin volume increases about 5 cubic feet to around 100 cubic feet total, and a lot of that goes to the back seat, which gains about 4 inches of legroom and an inch of headroom. Tons of room back here, really. I don't have any issues, and I'm about 6 feet tall. No center floor hump, really crowding footwell space. Excellent space back here. Lexus offers things like side window sun shades. Our test car doesn't have that, but a rear window shade, which our test car does have. A couple things missing, strangely, are heated rear seats and a rear climate zone. A lot of other kind of entry-level luxury cars offer those. The ES does not. The last ES had pretty good ride quality, and the new one preserves that with better steering feedback, especially if you take Lexus's drive mode selector and throw it into sport mode. The only thing really keeping the ES from hustling through corners is body roll, which remains pretty noticeable. The 3.5 liter V6 has a nice exhaust noise and definitely hustles the car, but our test car's 6-speed automatic tends to hunt for gears a lot. It's not that well prepared to kick down when you need it to. EPA mileage for the ES350 is 21 miles per gallon city and 31 highway, and where a lot of other entry luxury cars want premium gas, the ES350 runs fine on regular. Now, I wish Lexus had taken a page out of Audi's book and ditched some of the frills for consistent quality about the interior instead, but this car is no gussied up Toyota. It's arguably the best looking ES in 3 generations of the car, and that plus an EPA 40 miles per gallon for the ES300H hybrid should draw Lexus plenty of new buyers.
For more car-related news, go to Cars.com or our blog, KickingTires.net.